Hello, I'm Dr. Sarah Robinson-Schwartz, and I work at the National Institute for Neurological Disorders and Stroke, where I'm a neuroscientist, which means I study brains and brain cells and how they work.
Hi, I'm Dr. Ryan Richardson, and I also work at the National Institute of Neurological Disorders and Stroke, where I'm also a neuroscientist, which again means that I study how the brain works and how the cells grow. So today, Sarah and I are going to be walking you all through an activity to explore how the brain works. So to get us started, I'm going to ask some really simple questions. So what did you have for breakfast this morning, Sarah?
I think I had yogurt and fruit.
Okay. I think I had cereal. How about last week? What did you have for breakfast a week ago?
A week ago today? Might have been yogurt and fruit again. Might have been a bowl of cereal. I'm not sure.
How about a year ago?
Could have been anything, Ryan.
What about your earliest memory, Sarah? What was that?
My earliest memory, I was bit by a horse when I was 2. At least I think it's my earliest memory. I'm not sure I remember anything before that, but that one definitely stands out.
Yeah, I can imagine it might.
What about you, Ryan? Can you remember early things in your life?
I think my earliest memory is of the house I lived in Pennsylvania. And it was a big blue house at the end of the cul-de-sac.
So what would it be like if we weren't able to remember these things about our past? What if we couldn't remember where we lived or what we had for breakfast or who our friends were? What would that be like?
Yeah, I think that'd be really tough. Memory is such an important part of our everyday lives and how we interact with people, right?
Yeah, it's an important part of our everyday lives. It's an important part of school and learning. It's an important part of really everything that we do. So we're going to do a little test today, or a fun activity today, really, to see what memory is all about and how it works in our brains. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be reading a list of words for Ryan to try to remember, and you. We're going to have you do this activity along with us. And then we're going to have a little distractor activity where you're going to say the alphabet backwards. And then I'm going to read you back the list of words with a few extra ones thrown in to see whether or not you can remember which words you heard before and which ones you didn't. Do you think you're ready, Ryan?
I think so. We'll see how
it goes. Here's the list of words to remember.
Okay.
Mouse, banana, ball, peanut, wind, tape, tree, bird, acorn, bicycle, cookie, needle, star, fish, glue, flower, horn, glass, shoe. Those are the words.
Okay.
And now, yep. All right, you ready? We're going to have you and everyone watching along at home say the alphabet backwards to take a little break from these words.
Okay, let's see if I can do this. Z, Y, X, W, V, U, T, S, R, Q, P, O, N, M, L, K, J, I, H, G, F, E, D, C, B, A.
Okay. And now I'm going to be reading off a list of words. They include the words that I read at the beginning with a few extra ones thrown in. And if you remember me saying a word from the first list, raise your hand. If you don't remember the word, or if you think it's one of the extra words thrown in, don't raise your hand and we'll see how we do.
All right.
Ready?
Let's go.
Fish. Peanut. Needle. Mouse. Banana, monkey, tape, bird, paper, bicycle, hat, tree, glass, horn, jelly, shoe, glue, star, flower, wind, ball, car, acorn, cookie.
How'd I do?
You missed four words.
Okay.
Which is pretty good. So I read 20 words in the first round, and you got 16 of those 20 words right that you remembered them being said. And there were five distractor words or additional words thrown in that you actually correctly did not remember. So that's good.
Nice.
It's pretty good results, actually. I'm impressed. I'm not sure I could have done that well. So one of the things you might have noticed is that some of the last words might have felt a little bit easier to remember. Although I think you missed the very last word on the list, which was shoe. But you were able to get the glass and horn, which were some of the last few words. And so that's one of the features of our memory, is that some of the most recent things, the most proximity is what we call it, the things that are most close in time to us are a little bit easier to remember. Did you notice anything else about the words that you felt like you could remember or didn't, Ryan?
Yeah, it felt like it was easier to remember some of those first few words that you mentioned from that list.
Yeah, that's another feature of our memory. We tend to, it's a primacy effect. The very first things we hear, we tend to remember a little bit better. And the ones that are in the middle tend to get a little bit more jumbled up. They're not as easy to keep track of. We haven't formed those memories quite as strongly necessarily. Yeah. So what do you think? Why do you think I had you recite the alphabet backwards in between?
Because you wanted to torture me and make me look silly on camera?
Well, it was pretty entertaining watching you try to say the alphabet backwards. You did a really good job of that too. But no, it was actually to be a distraction, to give you your brain a little bit of a break. So the way we remember things is a couple of different kinds of memory. First is working memory. That's stuff that you're actively engaged in. Like if you're trying to remember somebody's phone number, you might repeat it over and over again in your brain.
Right.
Yeah. And so we wanted to stop you from that repetition and distract you a little bit to see if you actually were able to store those words in memory. And so
we also have longer term memory too, right? And
we do.
This is the sort of memory that you might see when you're trying to remember kind of things that happened long ago, or if you tried to remember lessons that you learned in class last week for a test that's coming up. Have this sort of longer term memory that you can pull from and retrieve these memories, right?
Exactly. Yeah. And as you noticed when we were talking about some of our earliest memories, they were all things that were really important to us or really shocking or particularly happy, particularly sad moments. And so those things are a little bit easier to remember when they have an emotion corresponding to them. Whereas things like your breakfast a year ago, yeah, a little bit harder to really remember that. It wasn't such an important event. It happens every day, but it's different every day.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully we gave you some things to think about with memory, and you can use the activity guide to try this activity at home and test out your memory with your friends and family.